Bonjour, bonsoir. Donc cette fois-ci, nous allons voir la dernière étape, voilà, de clés, voire maîtriser la langue anglaise. Donc c'est la cinquième et la dernière. Okay, donc nous allons la voir. Okay, donc c'est la pensée en anglais. Okay. Morning, afternoon, evening, brothers and sisters. Okay, so this is the last part of our English speaking strategies. The last part. So we'll see the We have seen the fourth one. We have seen let us recap them. We have seen listening. We have seen speaking. We have seen reading. After reading, we have seen writing. And this is the last part. I think that this is a little bit complicated, but every time it should be very easy and you will master it. This is thinking. Okay. So what thinking is? What thinking is? We all know thinking is part of the English language, and this will be very difficult, but you will improve it even if you want. So let's see what. Let's read this text from this. So, ok, donc comme je l'ai dit, la lecture, après les différentes étapes, c'est-à-dire l'écoute, le parler, la lecture, l'écrit, et ici nous sommes maintenant à la pensée, comment vous pensez en anglais, nous allons voir cela. Donc nous savons que cela fait le plus difficile, mais avec le temps ça va s'améliorer. Donc nous allons lire le petit texte et puis revenir. Voilà. Donc le thinking, c'est-à-dire la pensée, ok, pensée. Donc le thinking is a very important part of spoken English, because whatever you can think, you can speak. On dit que l'écoute est très importante, c'est une partie très importante dans la langue anglaise, parce que quoi que, tout ce que vous pensez, vous pouvez parler. Whatever. Quand vous pensez, vous pouvez parler, ok? Toutes vos pensées peuvent se transformer en des mots que vous allez pouvoir parler. Ok, so, make a habit to think in English. Donc, ayant cette habitude de penser en anglais. Nous savons que c'est un art, c'est une activité qui est très complexe, mais avec cette habitude de penser, d'essayer de réfléchir en anglais, ça va beaucoup nous aider. Ok, everything takes time. Chaque chose prend du temps. Pour ça, cette méthode-là, cette habitude n'est pas venue facilement comme ça, mais avec le temps, ça va aller, ça va aller. In the beginning, it will be difficult, but you will practice. But when you will practice and practice, it will be part of your memory. And once it becomes your habit, then English will become naturally from your mouth. Ok, comme vous le savez, donc au début ça sera une activité très facile et très une activité très, très difficile, mais lorsque vous pratiquez, okay, au fur et à mesure, ok, votre mémoire va s'habituer et ça sera une habitude de penser en anglais et les mots viendront aussi naturellement dans vos bouches et vous allez pouvoir parler, n'est-ce pas? So dear friends and sisters, you know that thinking is not easy at all. But if you think in English, you do your best. Whatever you can think, I think that you can speak it. If you can speak it, that's great. It will be very, very helpful. But if you don't, if you can speak what you think, with a habit, you try yourself every day. Okay, you will see your habit, your memory will be what you call a will be a habit of this, and you will see. Word will come to you naturally and you'll be able to speak English fluently, small at small. And this is our goal. So our goal is what? It will help you think in English. Speak English fluently as native speakers, isn't it? Yes, we can. Isn't it? Yes, we can. So let us recap what I said before. The first step is to be a good listener. Being a good listener is very important if you want to master the English language. Second step is to be a good speaker. If you are a good speaker, you can master the English language. Speak, speak, speak every day. Maybe in the morning, 20 minutes, in the afternoon, in the evening, 20 minutes. Okay? The first step is to be a reader. If you are a good reader, you can select 8 or 12 sentences from a page, 2 or 3 pages where you have read. Then you try to memorize, you try to understand the whole meaning of different sentences. It will be helpful for you to master this language. And also the fourth part is to write down. If you write everything you want, you will see it very important for you also to master it. And the last one, to think. Okay, if you start to think, you train your memory, your brain to speak it, to think in English and say what you think, and you'll see small or small, your English will be improved, and one day you'll achieve what the skill, which is speak English fluently, fluent speaker, and I'm sure you can. So let's together be a goals English speaker, isn't it? Okay, bye for now.